entire, if I can call it anti-Bru settlement agitation, do you think there was a scope to handle it much, much better than the way the government did? Mr. Kaur.
Of course. This government is practically dealing this matter only simple way, but it is not easy to deal it with a simple way. Practically, the Bru came here in the year 1993, most probably, and Left Front at that time is in power. We practically allow them, they have come, they lost their all belongings and land, etc., to of Mizoram. There is an ethnic problem between the two tribes there. After that, we allow them, they come, and we give all support to them for their livelihood. After that, we take up this matter with the Government of India. Government of India, after this long period, they have done this. But for the human being, we help them in this way. And all time, it is the problem of Mizoram. They come here and we pressure on the Government of India. The Mizoram government should take up all of them to their land. And give the settlement to there. It is the fact. But government of India failed to convince the Mizoram government to do this. This time also, some refugee has gone back to also by the help of the center and Mizoram government taken up this. But after that, they hold it. And some problems with their local people also, they are not, the Mizo refugee peoples, they are not willing to go there. For that,
we are aware of that, Mr. Pavitra Kaur. My next question to you: the protest was taking place for some time. Do you think the government also did not anticipate the violence, or did not properly reach out to the sections, in this case the JMC, which includes the Nagarik Moncho, which was protesting against the resettlement? Do you think the government did not see it coming, or was a bit lax?
Yes, it is there. They are not doing this sincerely. For that, practically, this problem arises again. But after that, they can make an agreement 1 year back with the Tripura government of India, and the Mizo people. They will settle here in Tripura. But it's a problem for Tripura government. And Tripura people also. As you see, 30,000 to 35,000 families are there.
Yes, Pradyut Debarman wants to make a point. We'll come to you in 30 seconds, Mr. Debarman. Yes, Pradyut Debarman, go ahead.
The honorable member from the Communist Party call our young people refugees?
I'm sure he didn't mean it.
Did he call our young people refugees? No. What do you mean, not mean it? How dare you call an Indian a refugee? How dare you call an indigenous person of Northeast a refugee? Tripura has had the history of accommodating all the displaced people from Bangladesh to our soil. We have kept them there. And today, in our own land, they will call us refugee. Either you take that word back, or we will. This is unacceptable. How dare you call an Indian a refugee?
Absolutely.
I refuse to take part in such debate where an indigenous person from Northeast, a Riang, is called a refugee, and the people we have accommodated, my ancestors have accommodated them in Tripura, and they are calling our people refugees. What is the legal definition of refugee in the Constitution of India?
Absolutely. Point taken.
How dare they say something like this? No, the Communist Party will have to pay the price for calling the indigenous people of Northeast, the indigenous people, our Bru brothers and sisters, refugees. We will see who are the refugees. Either the Communist Party takes that word away, or we will protest. This is unacceptable. This is 2020. We know what happened in Dumbur. We know how our young people, our Jamatia people were displaced. Mewar himself is testimony to that.
Absolutely.